So yesterday we discussed about what? Services. What is the purpose of a service? Service contains what? Business logic or requirement logic. Means all the requirement related server side communication will be there in your service. Means I want to communicate with the server, or I want to write the AJAX related logic. At the time I should go for what? Services. And services are singleton objects. What is singleton object? Only one object, because it contains business logic or not. I cannot create multiple objects for every need. So we have only one object. We can understand this point when we have multiple controllers. And since I will discuss that example later in the session, we can understand this point. Now tell me, if I have a common logic, how many objects I need to? If you have any voice related issue, so guys, I'm asking you to reconnect. I'm asking you to reconnect. Just close the webinar and reconnect to the webinar. So guys, common logic, Lakshmi, that is what I am telling. So if you are having any voice problem, just reconnect to the webinar once again. Guys, everyone able to hear my voice? Okay then. So who have the problems, just reconnect to the webinar. So guys, who creates this framework object? I'm asking the question, who is creating this frame, service object framework? Now what is our flow, guys? HTML will communicate with your controller. Controller will communicate with your services. Services finally communicate with your server. So right now, today, I'm going to recap the previous example once again. Then we can understand the, then we can go through the remaining application related thing. So right now, let me go to the examples. Now you can see, this is our previous example. Now, how you are converting your web page into the Angular web page. What is the JS file we need to include? I want everyone to interact in this session, and it is not a monologue. It is a means we need to have the discussion. So guys, what is the one we are having? What is the JS file we are including? Angular.js. What is the JS file we are including? Angular.js. What is the next one? All our application related code we are going to write in what JS file? App.js. All our application related code we should be there in what file? App.js. And how to create a module? I'm asking, what is the way of creating a module? Go to your app.js, and I'm creating what module? Student app module. And how to use the module? How to use the module in the HTML? How to use the module? S. Srikant, S. Syed, Santhi, Sahaji, Rahman, Madhu, Sushil, Raghupati. There are so many people in the webinar, but if you are responding, so guys, it is not a monologue, it is a bilogue. Means we need to give, everyone should give the answers. So guys, this is the way we are going to work it out. Now I am asking a simple question. How to use the controller? How to use the controller in the HTML? What is the tag we need to write it out? ng-controller. Very good, Srikant, Nijamuddin, Madhusekar, Rajesh. So guys, this is the way we are going to work it out. Very good, very good. What is the one we are going to configure? ng-controller. Now tell me guys, my requirement is I want to display students data which is available in the server. Which is available in the server. So at that time, what is the logic we are writing? What is the logic we are writing? Create a array or collection. How to create a collection variable in the controller? What is the object we are using? What is the memory for your controller? Scope. What is the memory for your controller? Scope. S. Arshia, Raju, and Sushil. Guys, this is the way we are going to work it out. Purushottam. So guys, what is the code we are writing? students. What is the code we are writing? Students equal to empty array. Initially, I want to make it as what? Empty array. But my requirement is what? Get it from the service. That's why we are making the service call or not. How to get this object? Are you creating or you are asking for framework? You are asking for framework. Observe where you are asking for this one. By in the function call or in the function definition, we are declaring or not. Means this controller required what objects? Scope object as well as what? Student to service object. So now tell me whose job to create these objects, your job or framework job? Framework. Now I am asking the question. Guys, so whose job to create this scope object and student service? Framework. So this is the way we are going to work it out. Now I am asking a simple question. Now tell me how to make the service call. What is the one? Object dot. What is the method we are having? Get students. Object dot. What is the method we are calling? Get students. Now tell me, I'm asking a simple question. It is a common sense related one. Now tell me, if you write the exam, you are going to pass as well as was there is a problem. Suppose if you don't write the exam properly, you are going to fail or no? So what is the outcome? You are going to pass or you are going to fail. In the same way, I am going to send the call to the server. I am going to call the server. Might be server will listen properly. Might be listen means the if the call is a legitimate or something, it is a valid. At the time, it will respond positively. Or sometimes server will fail or not. So what are the outcomes of this REST API call? The REST API call might be a success or might be a failure, like 404, as Rajesh, like 404, or might be 500. Means all these are status code of the HTTP protocol. What are the things? If it is 200, we have a success. If it is 404, we have a failure. And 500, it is a failure. Now tell me, always we are going to success or sometimes we will fail also? Most of the scenarios we are going to success. Sometimes we may fail. So the chance is there. That's why we need to write success function. We need to register success function as well as what? Failure function. Success function as well as what? Failure function. So right now F1 represents what? Success. F2 represents what? Failure. To register these callback functions, we are using what is the method? Then method. HTTP get will return a promise. That promise might be a success or might be a failure. So to register your success and callback functions, we are using what is a function? Then function. So today class, I'm going to show you the both scenarios and let's discuss the one. Yesterday's means we hurriedly write this code. Today, I'm going to show you the end-to-end example. So let me write the code for you guys. What is the first step? Always we are going to generate the code or not. Now tell me how to convert this web page into the Angular web page, right? Script tag and src equal to what is the one? Angular.js, and all our application code should be there in what? app.js, src equal to app.js, and create the corresponding files for us. Now I am asking a simple question. What is the first step we need to do? Create the module. Second step is what? Create the controller. Third step is what? Create a service. So this is the way we are going to work it out. S. Dhanlakshmi, Saurav, Anudipak. Good to see you, Anudipak. Nizamuddin. So now observe, I'm writing the code for module. Angular dot module, module name, comma, dependencies, student app. We created the module, sir. What is the next step? Create the controller. Angular dot module, module reference dot controller, module reference dot controller, student app, and what is the function I am going to use it? Controller. Now I need to write the student what controller? List controller. List functionality it is controlling now. Function, it should accept the related things. Now observe, it should accept what objects, guys? I am asking simple thing. My controller need to deal with the data. That's why we need to create the memory for this one or not. We are asking for the memory. In the same way, my controller need to communicate with the server. That's why we need to require what? Student service. We need to recreate what? Student service. So we created this one. Now I am asking a simple question. We need to provide the data binding. That's why scope dot, I want to work with one value or multiple values. Multiple values, how to represent multiple values in the JavaScript? How to represent? Yes, very good. Very good, Dhanlakshmi, Anudipak. I am seeing only few people. There are around 150 to 200 students are there, but very few people are responding. Guys, if you respond, you can understand the things. Even if it is right or wrong, I don't bother about this one. But participation, means expressing yourself, will make you better in this Angular framework. So that you can follow the class properly, and you can understand the things, and you can get the job. Once you understand the thing, you don't need to ask for the job. Automatically job will come for you. So guys, what is the one? Scope dot students will be there. Now I want to make the service call. So for this one, I need to write a service. Now tell me, what is the code I need to configure? What is the scope? What is the scope? Scope act as a memory for your controller. Scope acts as a what? Memory for your controller. Now I am asking how to create a service. Module reference dot, what is the method we are going to write it out? Service. Module reference dot, what is the method we are going to write it out? Service. I am asking, what is the service name we are going to configure? Student service. Now tell me, for student service, what is the functionality I required? I want to communicate with the server. Angular providing communicating with the server by using what service, guys? S Shanti, Srikant, Suresh, everyone. So those are the one. Now tell me, we required Ajax. That Ajax is provided by what is the one? $HTTP. By using what? $HTTP. Now tell me, what is the logic, what is the function argument I need to ask? $HTTP. Now observe, everything is ready. In this one, I have only one object. I don't have multiple objects. So that's why, what is the one we are going to configure? This function, what is the function name? Get students equal to function. Door closed. Return, what is the one we need to configure, guys? This dot get student equal to Vishnu Prasad. Very good. So what is the one? Return, what is the, whatever the data coming from the server, I need to configure. Means right now, what are the methods of the HTTP, guys? What are the methods we are having? Get post method, get method, put method, delete method. Now I am asking, So right now we have what method? Get method is there, post method is there, put method is there, delete method is there. So right now, what is the purpose of the get method? Accessing the data from the server. Accessing the data from the server. And what is the purpose of the post method? Sending the data for sending for insertion. Sending for insertion. What is the purpose of the get method? Accessing or retrieval. Our put method is what? Sending the data, sending for updation means, or deletion, asking for deletion. Now I am asking the simple question. If you want to send request and get the response from the server, what is the method I need to use it here, guys? Get method. I want to send for updation. At that time, go for what method? Put method. And I want to send for deletion. At that time, I need to go for what method? Delete method. I want to send for insertion. At that time, go for what method? Post method. All these methods are available in what service, guys? HTTP service. Available in what service? HTTP service. Who is providing the HTTP service? You are writing, our framework is providing. Angular framework, where we are declaring our service, guys, in your function, your student service function argument or not. Now tell me, who will create this object? Framework. Who will create this object? Framework. How many times it will create the object for your service layer? How many objects will be available? Only one object will be available. Only one object will be available. So this is what, as a developer, we need to use that. Now I am asking, I want to get the data. Get, provide the URL. So I already started my REST API server. It is running on localhost 3000 students. So this is my URL. Some people are asking, like, sir, what is this URL? So right now my server is running on this URL. Localhost means what? The current system, means in the same system I am running that. In the same way, what is the port number? 3000. What is the port number? 3000. So we are using, and in the same way, what is the resource I am accessing out? Students. Let me show you the representation I am getting from the server. Let me open the, you can observe. I started the server. Now you can see we are getting the data from the server or not. In the same way, observe, what is the URL I am asking now? What is the data I am asking now? Students data. Suppose I am asking for employees. So right now we are getting the employees related salary or not? Right now employees related salary. So right now we are asking for students related data. That's why what is the one we are calling? Localhost 3000. This server side code we need to develop by using what technologies? Java, .NET, or PHP, or we are going to use what? Node.js. We are going to use what? Node.js. If you have many service in one module, how many times we need to write the HTTP call? It is based on the need. For each and every time we need to make the HTTP call. But how many times the HTTP object is going to be created? Only one time. Sir, what is Node.js? Node.js, I want to write the code at server side also. JavaScript language. I want to use for server development also. At the time we can go with what? Node.js. Saurav, I answered your question. What is Node.js? I want to use JavaScript for server side development also. At the time, I should go for what? Node.js. Sir, how can we interact with DB? That's what I am telling guys. Your server code, .NET or Java application, will communicate with the database. We don't write the code. Is employee a table, many in database? Yes, we have the tables and we have the structures at the back end. That the back end data means who will write the select star from employee, Angular or it is your Java framework. We have what Java framework. Yes, I'm going to show you the live example for database communication soon, but we need to finish our client side coding first, right? So then we can see the server side coding. With the Java, .NET, PHP, as well as what? Node.js. But let me finish our server side code. Are you guys able to understand the things properly? So right now, we know how to create a HTML. We know how to create a controller. We know how to work with a services. Until this part, we have the clarity now. Now we want to communicate with your server. How to create this code also, I'm going to show you in the next sessions. But not today. Don't try to learn on the first day itself. It is a step-by-step process. It is a evaluation, not about the magic. There is no magic for the shortcut for the success, or there are no shortcuts for the success. Always the hard work pays you. So guys, that is the one. So let's see what is the one we are having. HTML should communicate with your controller. Controller should communicate with your services. Services uses what is a framework service for server side communication? $HTTP. So $HTTP contains what are the methods, guys? Four methods are there. Are other methods also there, but what are the methods? Get method, post method, put method, delete method. What is the purpose of them? Get method for accessing the data, put method for updation. I know you are asking for post or something, that's why I ask for what? Put method. Put method for what? Updation. Delete method for deletion. Delete method for what? Deletion. Likewise, we are going to have it. Now the example deals with what? Get method. So now tell me, this service call can be a success or a failure or not. So that's why we need to register what function. We need to register all our functions with what? Then function. We need to use what? Then function. So let me write the code. Student to service dot, what is the method I need to call, guys? Get students. We are making the service call, but we need to ready for positive scenario as well as what? Failure scenario. So right now, F1, this function deals with what? Success scenarios. F2, this function deals with what? Failure scenarios. Now I am asking a question. How to write a JavaScript function? Everyone listen. Function M1A. This is the way of creating a function in the JavaScript or not? Function, what function we define? M1. So the another way of declaration is what? A function without name is called as a what? Anonymous function. A function without name we call it as what? Anonymous function. So right now we have this function. Now tell me in the same way. Right now we need to declare two anonymous functions. One function deals with what? Success scenarios, and another function deals with what? Failure scenarios. So right now, let's see. fn. Here function let me organize the code. So right now this function deals with what? Success scenario. This function deals with what? Failure scenario. So success function deals with what? Server data, as well as failure function deals with what? Error one. So this is the way we are going to write it out. So guys, now tell me how to work with the positive and failure scenarios. What is the one we are using? What function? Then function. Now tell me, this is your server call or not? This is your server call. It is nothing but it will return what data? Either students data in what object? Server data. Otherwise it may return the error. Now tell me, whatever the server data, I need to assign to what object? Students. That's why what is the one we are going to configure? Scope dot students equal to server data. Server data dot, what is the one? It is having one property, data. In the same way, suppose some problem is there at the time, simply say alert data loading fail. Data loading fail. So this is the way we are going to work it out. Now tell me, right now, if we get the proper response from the server, it will call the first function or not? If I have a problem with the call, at the time it will call what? Second function. It will call second function. Now tell me, who is calling? You are calling or framework is calling? I'm asking a question. Who should call this one? Framework. Who should call this one? Framework. But who is registering? Developer. Who is registering? Developer. Now I am asking a simple question. I am making the call to the server. Now tell me, request now is in what? With the server. Server will communicate with the database and it will fetch the data and it will give in back to your services layer. Now tell me, in the services layer, it will execute your first function, but sometimes it responds come as a negative. At the time, negative means is what? Error. At the time, it will call your second function. So this is the way you are going to work it out. Now tell me guys, our coding at the controller is finished, services is finished, and we need to show the data in the UI. So let's configure the UI. What is the first step, guys? How to use the module? ng-app equal to student app. Div ng-controller equal to, what is the controller, guys, we are having? Everyone give the answer. What is the controller we are having? Student list controller. Student list controller. Now we have the controller. Now tell me, we are going to get one value or multiple values from the server? Multiple values from the server. That's why, what is the one, how you are going to show on the UI? I'm writing a table tag, and inside of this one I'm writing a tier, and in the same way inside of this one I'm writing td, and we have two properties. That's why we need to write two tds. Now observe here, what is the logic we need to configure? We need to configure ng-repeat equal to, what is the one? Student in, what is the collection, guys? I'm asking a question. What is the collection we are having in our controller? What is the reference variable? What is the reference variable we are having? Students. What is the reference variable? Nagateja Verma and Amir Sheikh and Priyatama. So what is the one we are having? Students. Very good. What is the next one? How to access this data, guys? What is our reference variable we are having? Student dot. What is the property I want to access it out? ID. Sir, how can you know all these properties? So right now you can observe, if I make the call, what are the properties of your object, guys? What is the first property? ID, and the value is 1, and name value equal to Satya. So what we need to configure here? ID. In the same way, the second TD bind with what property? Name property. Now everything is good. Let me open the web page. Open with Firefox. See, we are getting the data, right? You are getting the data, right? So this is the way we are going to configure. So this is your related thing. Now let me kill the server. What it is telling now? Data loading fail. So right now, why it is failed? Because is there any server to respond with this one? No. Automatically we need to inform to the user. There is a problem in the data fetch or not. We need to tell this one to the user. That's why it is calling what? Failure scenario. Now tell me, your call always a success? There might be a failure also. This might be a failure also. So at that time, what is the configuration we need to go for? What is the one we are going to use? What function? Then function. We are going to use what function? Then function. Then function used to represent what are the scenarios, guys? Success scenarios as well as what? Failure scenarios. Now I am asking the things once again. I am writing the whole code once again. What is your job? You need to tell what I need to write. So I am asking the question one by one, and you need to give the answers, and then we can call the thing. Okay, let's do this exercise. I am removing everything. Now tell me, what is the first step in Angular creation process? What is the one? Module. First we need to create the module. I want everyone to respond to this one, guys. Type it in your create module. What is the next one? What? Create. What is the one? Controller. Very good. Santi, Nagatej Verma, Mahesh, Aswin, Rajesh, Karthik. What is the next step, guys? Creating your service. Very good. What is the one we are going to provide? Service. Now tell me, what is the first step we need to do? How to create a module? By using Angular API, Angular dot, what is the one? Module. What is the module name I am giving? Student app. What is the module name we are giving? Student app. Now we created a module. Now I can use my module reference to create the controller and to create the service. So very simple one. What is the logic we are going to configure? Reference dot, what is the method we are going to configure? Controller. So right now, how to get the reference variable? By using the module method, by passing only module name. So dot, what is the one we are going to configure? Controller. And what is the next one? Student list controller. comma, we are going to write what? Function. Now tell me this function, I want memory. I want memory for your function, means controller. What is the object we need to pass on? Scope object. Very good, guys. I am very happy. So what is the one we are going to have? It dollar scope, comma, we need to communicate with your server. At the time, what is the object we require? Service name. So right now, standard service name I am using. What is the service name? Student service. Now I am asking, this student service is user created or framework provided? User defined. But observe, who create the object for this one? Who create the object for your service, student service? Framework. Very, very important one. Who create this object for this one? Framework. Narasimha, Srikanth Reddy, Aswin, Venu, guys, Purushottam. Very good, guys. What is the one we are having? In the same way, dollar scope, it is a memory for representing for the current controller. And Saurav, that is a very good question, sir. Why it is singleton? We can discuss, and we have a separate session on why singleton. That is a very, very important interview question, and I am going to explain in the next sessions. But remember, it should be a singleton. Why it is a singleton, we are going to have separate session. Very good question. So if you have a doubt, ask me in the questions window when the class is going on. So that is the way we can observe this one. Now we have this one, we have a controller, dollar scope dot, what is the variable we are going to configure? Students. And observe, it deals with what? A group of values and empty array. Now I am asking, what is the next step? Creating a service. What is the method we are going to configure? Module reference dot, what is the method? Service method. Module reference dot, what is the method? Service method. Service, what is our service name, guys? What is our service name? Student service. Now in the same way, for service, what are the dependencies or what are the objects I required? What are the objects I required for service, guys? $HTTP. Very good, very good. So respond to this one. Vishnu Prasad, good to see you. Nizamuddin, Rajendra Prasad, everyone is right. Sunil Kumar. So right now, how to create a function inside of this one? What is the code? Then dot, what is the one? Sorry, this dot, what is the one? This dot get method name. Very good. This dot method name, get student, get students equal to function. This is the way. Now observe, what is the requirement I need to do? Whatever the data coming from the server, I need to return this dot dollar, what is the one? HTTP dot, what is the method? Get method. HTTP dot get method. What is the URL for this one? HTTP:// what is the one? localhost:// what is the one? 3000/students. I have a valid question. I want to answer this question. Now observe, there is a question like, sir, if at all there are so many things are there, sir, how to decide? Nagireddy, what is the one, sir? If multiple services are there, then how the framework knows which service object to pass to the controller? So right now, what is our service name? Student service. This should matches with this one. If it doesn't matches, it cannot pass the object. That is the way it's going to be worked out. Now the question is how to work with the services in detail. We will have the session on the thing. So we are going to this one. Now tell me, we need to give this data to the service from the controller layer or not? What is the call we need to make here? Student to service dot get, what is the method? Students. This is your service call. Now tell me, this service call can be a success or a failure. That's why what is the one we are configuring? Then function. We need to configure what function? Then function. So this is the way we are going to work it out. On this then function, we need to make the call what? Create what? Function one as well as what? Function two. I am asking the question, what is function one? What is function one? Very good, very good. Positive response handling, or it is for what? Success. What is function two? To handle what scenario? Function two, error or failure scenario. Very good, Santi and Raju. And but I'm seeing very few, means around 40 to 50 students are only responding, and everyone should respond, guys. Everyone should respond. So F1 deals with what scenario? Success scenarios. F2 deals with what scenarios? Failure scenarios. Failure scenarios. So let me configure this one now. Yes, Arshia, we can make the call to different services also. We can have this discussion in the separate session. So right now, what is the one we are going to configure? We are going to write normal function or anonymous function here. Normal function or anonymous function. Anonymous function. A function without name is called as a what? A function without name is called as a what? Anonymous function. A function without name is called as a what? Anonymous function. So right now, let me write the code in better way. So this is your then. Function server data. Comma. What is the function we are writing? Next function is what? Function accepts what? Error. So this is your server related handling or not? Now you can observe this function deals with what? Server data. This function deal with what? Failure data. Now observe. How to handle the data means this data we need to give it to the controller or not. So what is the controller variable? Students. Scope dot students equal to what is the one we are going to configure? Whatever the data coming from the server, it is having one property. What is the property? Data property. So data property. Now I am asking, means I am going to write the whatever the server data object. Let me show you what exactly it contains. In the same way, whenever we are getting the problem, what is the one? Alert. Window.alert is going to be call it out. We can call all the JavaScript functions from your Angular. Angular. We can call all the JavaScript functions. So alert data. Data loading failed. Data loading failed. As well as in the console, console.log, console.log error. So one person is asking, sir, this one is fixed. You can configure ABC also. Don't bother about that, and don't have assumptions like this one should be fixed. But what is fixed? Your data is available as a what property? Data. Your server side response is available as a what property? Data. But this variable can be anything. This variable can be anything. So this is what. But observe, I am a good developer, so I need to name my variable in good way or not. Instead of A, B or something, you can configure like this also. This is your response object. On this response object, we are using what property? Data property. I am using what property? Data property. So, but my response, I am going to call it as what? Server data. Now, let me get this one. run the server is now I want to show you something. This is what we get the response from the server. This is what we get the response from the server. So right now, what are the predefined properties are there in the server side response? Data, what is the status, and the remaining things. Now tell me, I'm asking a simple question. Try to understand the question. Where exactly our server-side response or server-side is there available? Data, Karthik, very good. What is the one we are having? Data. I want to know the status. At the time, what is the property? Status. What is the status we are having? 200. 200 means what? Success. 200 is nothing but success. So this is the way we are going to work with our data related things. Guys, what is 404? Error. 500. Error. So in the same way, let me show you the error also. Is there any specific reason for using anonymous function? So unnecessarily, I don't want to create another function outside of the things. That's why we will go for what? Anonymous function. There is no specific reason. You can create the things also. Sir, this then function has any more arguments to define? Any more arguments to define? Success, failure, having only two, this one. So right now, if it is error, what is the status here we are going to have it? You can observe what is the status it is telling. Data, null, as well as what status equal to what? Minus one. Means unable to get the data from the server. Mansoor Ali Khan, I'm going to show you this debugging on next session. So guys, we have the next session on Wednesday once again. So I'm asking you to work on these examples from the day one. So it is available in your server related one and learn it. Tomorrow, Saturday and Sunday, we don't have the sessions, and only we have the session on Wednesday once again. So guys, second May. So we are going to have the session on 2nd May once again. I have some personal issue, so I need to take care. Sorry for this one. I'm very sorry. I want to take the class, but there is some personal reason is there. That's why I need to attend. So guys, so what is when we have the session once again? Wednesday.